This video will demonstrate the UV flatten tool in Houdini. We'll start by selecting the seams on the head where we want to make our cuts. Hit the 3 key to pick edges. We're going to choose the cut geometry for UV layout option. This setting allows us to keep and display all edge selections we make, which will help us to visualize how our geometry will unwrap. Let's turn on color groups display. And now we go to make our cuts. Hold down A for partial loop selection. And let's grab all the seams. Just keep in mind, you don't need to hold down Shift to make additional edge selections. And you can also deselect edges by holding down Ctrl and A and clicking to deselect. Now we're going to group these edges. Go to the Model Shelf tab and click on Group. Deselect the edges and let's zoom in on our nodal network and make sure that our grouped edge selections are there. Yep, they are. Let's go to the Texture Shelf tools and click on UV Flatten. Turn off Select Visible Geometry Only and then grab all the faces and hit Enter and enter again. Change one of the views to UV Viewport if you don't have it already. Now, why aren't we getting our seam selections fed in? Because we need to set the seam group to the group node first. Now we're going to turn on Visualizer for UV distortion. And right mouse button click over the button to make sure that UV distortion box is ticked. And now we're going to take a look at the Visualizer settings. Here are our current settings, but you can also customize them as you like. Let's just maximize our windows here. And we'll hit spacebar B to expand the UV viewport. So, in UV Flatten, we have a few tools that help us to edit our newly made UV islands. We can drop down some pins to help us manipulate our UV islands. Simply click wherever you wish to assign them. You can drop pins on your geometry in the perspective view too. It's not only restricted to the UV viewport. You can either click and drag on a pin to move it around, or you can hit 5 for UV vertices and pick which vertices you want to pin down using vertices to pin. Hold down Shift key to select additional vertices, and hit the Enter key to assign pins to those selected vertices. Now we click back on Pins to Manipulate button, and we can select the pins that we want to move. And let's move them around. You can unpin vertices by selecting pins and hitting the Delete key. And if we wanted to make more cuts to existing UV islands, simply click on Edges to Cut and select your edges. Hit the Entry key to complete the operation. Let's undo that, and we'll hit spacebar B to get back our side-by-side windows, and hit the 4 key to switch the faces. And we're going to throw down a UV checker on our geometry using UV Quickshade so that we can have a better idea of seams and distortions for texturing purposes later on. With all the faces selected, click on UV Quickshade. Hit Ctrl B to bring back our full workspace. And you can change the default UV checker. In addition to the grayscale option, there is also a color flavor too, or you can use your own. Let's just turn off display on group list. Now let's just change the file that texture map is pointing to. And there's our color option. And now we're back to the default grayscale UV checker. You can do the same with the UV checker in the UV viewport. Hit the D key to bring up the Display Options window, and hit the D key to close it, and we can switch it back to the grayscale option. And that is UV Flatten and some of the UV tools inside Houdini. Stay tuned for future UV tool videos.